Assalamualaikum and a very good afternoon to all the panels and my fellow friends. So today I would like to present my final year project progress, which the title is Diversity of Small Mammals in the Island and Mainland. I am Nur Hafifah binti Razali, supervised by Professor Dr. Muhammad Tajuddin Abdullah and co-supervised by Associate Professor Dr. Nobuyuki Yamaguchi. For introduction, my study focuses on rodent. The rodent is the largest order of mammals in the world, comprising 2,277 species, 31% of which the small mammal species, 481 genera and 33 families. Southeast Asia supports a huge diversity of small mammals, which play an important role in terrestrial ecosystem. And they also colonize many different habitat types in the course of evolution, resulting from their high diversity. They are also a key link in the food chain, with many species preying on insects and other larger invertebrates. So these two pictures show the captured species. The first one is Calocereus nodatus, which I have caught in Pulau Bidong. The second one is Calocereus primosti, which I have caught in Marapo, Pahang. The objective is to study the species diversity of small mammals in the island and mainland. The second one is to compare the species diversity of small mammals between the island and mainland. So the picture here shows the species of Maximus raja and the species caught in Sauk Tasik Kenyir. For the meteorology part, this map shows the different location of study site in Terengganu State of Peninsular Malaysia. Overall, there are six different locations that I have to go, which the first one is Pulau Perhentian, the second one Pulau Bidong, Pulau Redang, Sungai Rela, Marapo, Pahang, South Tasik Kenyir and Biowalk MMT. As for now, I have finished sampling in Pulau Perhentian, Pulau Bidong, Pulau Redang, Marapo, Pahang and also South Tasik Kenyir. So currently, I am going to do my sampling in Biowalk UMT campus. For the trapping method, 50 cage trap used and weighed with banana for each sampling site, and it is placed in each 10 meter apart from one to another. And the cage trap were checked regularly, 3 times daily, which is at 6:30 a.m., 12 p.m. and 6:30 p.m. And then the samples brought back to the base camp to be identified and processed. For the identification method, the trap rodents were identified up to species level, and these are pictures of I am doing the measuring process. The morphological measurement were taken using digital vernier caliper and also ruler. The morphological measurement were taken such as ear, head body, tail as for the weight, electronic weighing scale used, and this book that I used to identify the species, and then all the measurement recorded in the data sheet, and after the identification process, the sample will be released back. And the sample will release back to its habitat. From my preliminary result, this table shows the taxonomic list of species and individuals in the sampling site. From this table, it can be seen that the species of the Tupayaglis have recorded the most captured species in Pulau Redang, and among all the species, only one species stated as vulnerable in IUCN 2020, which is Maximus raja. The Shannon Index in South Tasik Kenyir has recorded the highest number of index, and also for the Immunis index. For the data collected, island has recorded 32 individuals, for mainland has recorded 7 individuals, sorry. For number of species, both has the same, and for Shannon index, mainland has recorded the highest index, and also for the evenness. And for the dominant species, and for mainland, also have to buy a list and protest. This figure shows the number of individuals in different sampling site. So, in Pulau Redang, it's recorded the most captured species of Tupaia gris, and also for the Pulau Perhentian. And this graph shows the individuals that present in graph for all the species. For the Venn diagram, Island has recorded 3 species and also Island has recorded 5 species and also mainland, and the overlap is 2 species, which the species have the same in Island and also mainland, which the first one is Pyaglis and also Rhynchus rhynchus. For the problems and solution, the first one is not many species of small mammals breeding on the ground, because the small mammals more likely to jump from the branches of trees to trees, and my solution is I climb up the trees and hang up the cage trap up on the trees. Second one is the appearance of monkeys disturbing the cage trap, and the monkeys will took some of the bait that were in the cage trap, and my solution is I check the cage trap regularly and we renew the bait if the bait were missing. The third one is the cage trap will be missing because of the color of the spot is the same, and my solution is I put the caution tape on the trees where the cage trap will be placed. For my future plan or activity, the first one is to complete the sampling in UMT campus. Second one is to run the data analysis in the end of March. And the third one is writing on finding new project. So this is the Gantt chart, shows the progress and planning through the years. These are references used. This is the appendix or data sheet. So that's all from me. Thank you.
I was expecting that you have more of Colescaris notatus, but then I'm very surprised you have a lot of Pyaglis. Is there an explanation for that thing to occur?
Pyaglis is the tree shrew, and it is one of the most common species that I have caught.
Yeah, is there any explanation why you have caught a lot of Pyaglis? Is it because of the habitat or because people are hunting the notatus? Or somebody is eating the notatus? Pyaglis is up there,
yes.
And notatus is very low. Normally is the reverse. Sometimes Colescaris notatus are related to the pokok kelapa. So you may want to find out what are the other agricultural plant that may attract to Pyaglis, okay? So that might explain why you have certain species more than the others. Okay.